ignition engineer spark plugs, including the sensational Autolite resistor spark plugs and the dependable Autolite stay full battery. Autolite makes over 400 products for cars and trucks, bumpers and hubcaps, radiator grills and ornaments, bullseye steel beam headlights, ignition system, spark plugs, batteries, fuel pumps, windshield wipers, instruments and gauges, wire and battery cables, and many more. So remember, from bumper to tail light, you're always right with Autolite. And now, Autolite and its 96,000 dealers everywhere present Suspense. The accomplished Prince Florizel of Bohemia gained the affection of all classes by the seduction of his manner and by a well-considered generosity. Now and then, when he fell into a low mood, he would summon his confidant and master of the horse, Colonel Gerard, and bid him prepare himself for a night of adventure to be undertaken in cognizance.
There, Your Highness. Name me.
I prefer the latter. I know more of law than of pill.
I shall call myself Mr. Theophilus Good.
Now let us drink, whatever the night may bring forth.
Here's to
the death of Ford.
And your highness's safety.
I don't think I want to drink to that.
Danger and adventure rarely go hand in hand with safety. May I respectfully remind Mr. Good that he is the heir to the throne. That limits the risk that your highness should run.
Gerard, how many times have you uttered that warning?
I've lost count, sir. And have I ever heeded it?
You constantly disregard it, sir. And I shall do the same tonight. So cease talking like a timid lady in waiting, or you'll dampen our evening.
How many oysters have you got?
Well, not a scrap. I guess I ain't counted the six nanos, so it's a ton of that. I suppose you want to buy them up.
That's exactly what I do want.
My friend, Mr. Alfred Tennant.
And your name, sir?
Shall we say, Mr. X?
A real name I should give to myself, as you have done.
Would it be an impertinence to ask the reason for your feeding succulent mollusks to this rabble?
Not at all. Only 2 months ago, I met a young lady with whom I fell madly in love. She spurned me. Since then, she has made a good marriage. And I have tried to bury my sadness in increasing my expenditure. The purchase of those oysters was a last and futile gesture. Now nothing at all remains of my capital.
Isn't it odd that we three should have met by the merest chance and be in the same condition?
So you two are penniless?
Oh, and worse, disgraced. The devil himself must have brought us together for this last carouse.
Last carouse?
And you shall wish to put an end to life.
Well, yes.
Only a moment ago we were planning just such a final indulgence. This is indeed a miraculous coincidence. It's more than that. It's a sign. Why put off the fatal moment any longer, Hammersmith? Let it be tonight and at once, all three together. Such a hapless trio should go on and on for all the future.
Agreed. Let us drink to that.
Now is the method. Have you any suggestions?
It's ready just like a new breed of crime. Not enough
here is all I have left in the world.
It's another form of
stolen pounds. Leave
the kids alone.
Each of you must have a similar amount.
My mother lives with our son. But Mr. Hammersmith may be able to lie.
I have 80 pounds. Why?
Then we are indeed looking.
40 pounds is the entrance fee to the suicide club.
The suicide club? In the devil's name, what's that?
Yes, private door. The suicide club was organized to accommodate those who wish to shuffle off this mortal coil without scandal. You gentlemen truly are proud of life as you say you are. I can introduce you with the leading of the club tonight.
That's just what we've been looking for, eh, Hammersmith?
Yes, indeed.
A unique, unknown method of departure.
Fascinating.
You're correct. We accept your gracious offer. You may lead us. Death private door.
I'm gonna stop this crime, so don't help me do it. Come on, buddy, keep your head into it.
Here's my destination.
Number
13. But it's
still
time, Mr. President.
Come back.
I'm not the man who changed my mind.
Next morning.
Good evening. May I help you, gentlemen?
We are anxious to become members of your club.
Reasons?
We have no use for further life.
Oh, come, come, sir. We must have more than that.
Frankly, I would send you packing were you not with this young gentleman who is known to me. Many of his friends are sleeping happily in the tomb due to my organization.
What exactly do you want?
Data! As to why you've been brought to this, shall we say, grave decision? This is strictly for my record, you understand. While we are tacit as to model judgment, we are also meticulous in the extreme.
Very long. Very well, Mr. President. My friend and I.
Parents of the world, before I go,
there's more joint planning to make you sit no, no dollar because time we have enough. You're at the end of our financial tether. No other court, but
don't you believe in Christ your Savior? Pray to God not to the
well, that's much better.
You can warn
in fact, I think I can conscientiously say that it's qualified. But, you can pay the boatman the necessary toll.
Give him the money, Hammersmith.
To be correct. Now, gentlemen, before I accept this, there is a little matter of an oath which you must swear.
An oath? Demanding what, Colin?
Strict obedience to our rules.
What are the rules?
We'll be told after you sign the oath.
That seems to be most one-sided. I demand an oath of what I'm committing myself.
Those are my conditions, sir. you and your friend have any qualms, the door back to the outside world is still open.
For my part, that door is closed forever. Very well, Mr. President. I accept your conditions. Let me read this oath. Forfeited an oath so awful, would never have a rag of honor left to him.
Nor could he speak his maker of his judgment.
Nevertheless, another time. And I.
Gentlemen, you put me to shame. Give me that pen.
Dear friends, you are at last in sight of that undiscovered country from whose bourn no traveler returns. Follow me, gentlemen. I shall introduce you to our oldest member. It is his function to tell you exactly how you will die.
Second act of our suspense story, The Suicide Club.
I apologize for breaking in on your records, Mr. Malthus, but we have three new members. They wish for information.
Then they have come to the right course, Mr. President. Will you please be seated?
You will forgive me, gentlemen. I have my duties as a host.
A genius in his way. Now, what is it you wish to know?
How this organization works?
It is a perfection of completion. A member who comes here in such a death like yourself returns every evening and through talk. And when the game is over, he makes the necessary arrangements. I believe him to be in touch, indeed. Yes, touch. Perhaps you remember from the great escape of the soul of a certain nobleman who was accidentally poisoned in a tennis shop. That was one of his lesser features. Simple, household talk. And you say that unfortunate gentleman was a member of this club.
Yes, my dear sir, that fortunate gentleman.
Back in the very square where you sit now, the night before he died.
How was it decided that he was to be the happy victim?
What game he played? The president uses an ordinary tax card. He deals one card to each member until two have appeared. The ace of spades. That is the card of death. The ace of clubs. That designates two to be the executioner.
One member destroys another.
Yes, that will lead the danger of it all. And also, it's thanks to the brilliant mind of the president, no Ace of Clubs has ever been in doubt.
Very nice. Fate may decide that one of us made it for the other.
Infamous news. If, as in my case, chance
lengthens your life, you will appreciate that this game combines all the thrills of the gambling table, a duel and a romantic all amusement works in fashion. Ah, but we like to heaven and see the game with the hot skin.
They get lucky too late to make our escape. They like gentlemen, however, I escape.
And in usual with our game, gentlemen, we will preserve the common sight.
Bartholomew Malthus, 16 Chepstow Place, Westbourne Grove, fell over the upper parapet in Trafalgar Square. Death was instantaneous. Mr. Malthus was known to be subject to occasional attacks of paralysis. It is thought that his fall may have been caused by another seizure.
That poor young Mr. X. If ever was a man with a soul in hell, it must be his.
Last night he was as innocent as you or I. This morning there's blood on him.
When I think of the president of that vile society, battening and battening on the weakness of distorted mind, Gerard, never in my entire life have I felt myself so shaken with rage. And I vow before God I'll make that jackal pay for his iniquities. I could go to the authorities, not without forfeiting your honor, Gerard. You, I, all the members have sworn an oath that few would dare to break. And what proof would there be?
Remember, the president himself never lays a finger on his victim. No, Gerard, my mind's made up. Tonight, once more, I take my seat at the table of the suicide club.
Ah, my dear sir. My heartiest commendations. An excellent night's work. I'm grateful that the Morpheus proceed for your appeal. Grateful.
Great God, I saw
the escape tonight. Yeah, we can come. You heard the old man scream at his elbow. Come,
sir, you must take it to a fast lane.
Think of yourself as a soldier.
Are
you
mixed
in an army of death for me?
I can think of myself only as a murderer.
In the world, there's a way.
the car. I'm looking for you gentlemen who have reason.
Four of you. The odds of exciting the short.
Shall we begin?
All right. She's a cookie soon. The odds will be 5-1. The fun is just about to begin, gentlemen.
Please excuse our being late, Mr. President. We were unable to find a conveyance. The streets are deserted. The fog is so dense that only the desperate are abroad tonight.
Gentlemen, will leave as quickly as possible. I shall the sooner be able to conclude my business with the two lucky ones. I'm very happy to have met you, sir, and to be in a position to do you this trifling service. One thing, you cannot complain of delay. On the second evening, what a stroke of luck. You look a little sickish, sir. Most gentlemen do when it comes to the final moment.
What instructions have you for me, Mr. President?
They're very simple. You will make your way on foot down this alley to the Thames Embankment. You know the monument, Cleopatra's Needle?
Certainly.
You may or may not get that far. Whatever happens, you are to offer no resistance. That is one of the rules which you have sworn to obey. One thing I can promise you, it means this way, pardon. That is all. Wait in the anteroom 5 minutes and then...
My thanks. You've saved me from the boredom of old age.
I wish you a pleasant stroll in the park, sir. Now, sir, listen to my instructions carefully. But first, put this in your pocket. I am rather suspicious of our friend, Mr. Goods. I found it best to anticipate any difficulties. So please, listen to these instructions most carefully. You will leave by the rear exit. You will then proceed.
Gerard. Gerard. Mr. Hammersmith.
Of a drubbing, sir.
He saved me from the watery grave. Oh, word. That scoundrel of a president lets it go unpunished.
He won't, sir. This morning I thought that the William Warren would be asleep. At the moment, the suicide club is surrounded. The president will be apprehended as he leaves. He will be arraigned and charged as being an accessory to the murder.
On what evidence?
On the written evidence in his own letters. I purloined them while he was signing your death warrant.
Magnificent, Gerard. That was surely convicted.
Then it will be his turn. Draw the ace of sticks.
Friends, this is Rex Marshall speaking for Autolite.
And I'd like you to know that more and more people are buying Autolite stay-full batteries, the batteries that need water only three times a year in normal car use. Now, one of the big reasons is that the stay-full battery practically eliminates one of the major causes of battery failure, and that is lack of water. You see, when your battery is dry, it fails and your car won't start. Yes, the Autolite stay-full is the battery that needs water only three times a year in normal car use, because it has a greater liquid reserve above the plate. And in addition, it's the battery that gives you longer life. Tests have shown that the Autolite stay-full battery gives 70% longer average life than batteries without the stay-full feature. So, see your Autolite battery dealer tomorrow and have an Autolite stay-full battery installed in your car. Money cannot buy a better battery. Remember, you're always right with Autolite.
This is CBS, the Columbia Broadcasting System.